Good morning, students. See, in the morning you have given IIT paper, that is IIT test number 3. Okay, so now it is time to discuss our paper. Whatever the questions are given, so that and that answers we are going to discuss now. So see, I have sent you PDF also. In that PDF, all questions and answers are given. Okay, if it is possible, take printout. Otherwise, you write that all questions in your chemistry notebook. So now we will discuss the question number 1. See here, the question number 1 is the best electrical conductor is. Okay, so see this, it is very easy question. The best electrical conductor, see, we know that the common what we are using, copper, but here the written it is the best electrical conductor. So the answer is option C, that is silver. Okay, so which is the correct answer? Answer option number C. Now see the second one. All materials shown property of malleability except, see here, all metals are given, okay, means all materials, the substances are given, in that which one is not shown malleability, okay, that you have to identify. So which one will be the correct answer? The correct answer is a graphite. Okay, now see the question number 3, that is rusting of iron takes place in. Now rusting of iron takes place in ordinary water, distilled water, both ordinary and distilled water, none of the above. See, rusting of iron means what? When iron come contact with oxygen and water, it started rusting. Okay, so after some times the rust is formed on that metal. So it will takes place in the both ordinary and distilled water. Now see the question number 4. Which of the following property is generally not shown by metals? Okay, so here some properties are given, but you have to identify which one is not shown by metal. Means see here, electrical conduction. Second one, sonorous in nature. Option C, dullness. And option D, ductile. So you know that the metals are lustrous, okay, so they are having shine. So the property C, it is given, that is a dullness, it is a wrong. So correct option is option C. Now see question number 5. Since metal produce ringing sound, they are said to be sonorous, okay, because it shows a sonorous property. Now see question number 6. The non-metal which is liquid at room temperature is. Now you have to read carefully question. What they ask? They ask about non-metal, not a metal. Okay. The non-metal which is liquid at room temperature, that is, options are given mercury, bromine, carbon and helium. Okay, so which one is the correct option? Option B, that is a bromine. See, here non-metal is very important word. Which one is a non-metal? Means mostly other all non-metals are in solid state or gaseous state. Okay, but only one exceptional case, that is a bromine, is in a liquid state. Okay, now we will see a next question, that is question number 7. See question number 7. The number of protons in an atom of an element A is 19. See, I have written here that question. The number of protons in an atom of an element A is 19. Then the number of electrons in its ion A plus is. Here you have to identify if ion, now see, cations and anions, that we learn. Okay, so these questions in between I given for you. See here, option A 80, option B 90, option C 20 and D is 21. So you know that everyone, number of protons is equal to number of electrons. Okay, so electrons in A, because here it is given the number of protons in an atom. See here, the number of protons in an atom of an element A is 19. So number of protons 19 means number of electrons also 19. So therefore the electrons in A is equal to 19. Now see, now in A plus, now A plus means what here? It is positive charge is given. So why it is positive charge? Because if if any element lost electrons, then it get the positive charge. So see, now in A plus ion, positive charge is acquired by loss of one electron. See here plus, only one plus sign, positive sign it is given, means what? One electron loss. So what we have to do here, see, the number of electrons in ion A plus is equal to 19 minus 1. Why 1? Because here only a plus sign it is given, here no number it is given, so only 1 is there, okay? So 19 minus 1, what will be the electrons? 18. So which is a correct option? See, option A is a correct, because number of electrons in this positive ion, that is a 18. Okay, see, this whole answer I have given in the PDF also, so you can check it. Now see the question number 8. Question number 8, which of the following represent the correct order of decreasing reactivity? Now reactivity series, you know that, so you just have to identify. So which one is in a decreasing order of reactivity series? So which answer will be the correct? See, answer option A. Okay, the option A is a correct. Now see question number 19, that is which of the following the pair of a reactant? Question number 9. Okay, see question number 9. Which of the following pairs of reactant will undergo a displacement reaction? Now here, in which reaction displacement reaction will occur, that you have to identify. Now here also you have to think about a reactivity series. Okay, so option A is given, CuSO4 plus Fe. See what is the option. Okay, see question number 9, options are given. Option number 1, CA is CuSO4 plus Fe. Okay, B is ZnSO4 plus Fe, MgSO4 plus Fe, and CaSO4 twice plus Fe. Now here what you have to think, you just have to think about the reactivity series. Okay, see, Fe and Cu, which one is more reactive? See, Fe is more reactive than Cu. See here the reactivity series are given here. See, this is the Fe and Cu. So Fe is more reactive than Cu. So Fe can take place of, see what, FeSO4. The product will form, that is FeSO4. So here what, the displacement reaction takes place. Okay, but why not in other option C? Now ZnFe, you just have to think about, see, Zn is more reactive than Fe. So here the displacement reaction will not take place. Then say MgFe. See where is Mg? Mg is also more reactive than Fe. So here also this displacement reaction will not take place. Now Ca and Fe. Now see here, calcium is more reactive than Fe. Okay, so in which option displacement reaction will take place? That is option A, CuSO4 plus Fe. So this A option is correct. Now see the next question. Question number 10, galvanization is a method of protecting steel and iron from rusting by coating them with a thin layer of. This is very a simple question. The galvanization, in this galvanization process, which coating, which metal coating we are giving to the iron object to prevent from rust. Okay, so the answer, correct option is zinc. Okay, so option C is correct. Now see the next question. An element X is a soft and can be cut with the help of knife. Now see here, means in the first sentence also you just have to think about. Now here it is an element, X is a soft and can cut with the help of knife. It is very reactive to air and cannot be kept open in the air. It reacts vigorously with the water. Identify the element from the following. Okay, so you know that which one is a very reactive in air. Okay, so what will be the correct option? That is a sodium, Na. Okay, now see the next. Common brass is a alloy of. Now alloy means what? It is the mixture of more than one metal. Okay, it is the mixture of the metals. So brass is a alloy of copper and zinc. So option C is a correct. Now see the next question, that is question number 13. Which of the following metal is the most reactive metal among the following? Now here also you just have to look for to this reactivity series and identify. So which one will be the correct answer? That is a iron. Okay, now see the question number 14. The gas released when metal react with water. See, we have discussed when we were learning about the metals and non-metals in the chemical properties. So whenever the metals react with water, hydrogen gas is released. Now see the question number 15. In the given chemical reaction, which metal is more reactive? Okay, so the chemical reaction it is given and you have to identify which one is more reactive. Now see in this chemical reaction, which are the metals? Just first what? First you write down all the questions whichever it is given in the PDF file and then you see this video. Okay, so see the Zn is a more reactive than other metals. Now see the next, number of valence electron in potassium. It is also one extra question for you, but it is already the completed point. So number of valence electron in a potassium valence electrons means what? Whatever the electrons are present in the outermost shell, that electrons are known as a valence electron. So potassium option correct answer is 1. Okay, and see most of the time we are writing K plus means what? Plus 1 only it is given, so 1 answer. Now see the next question number 17. Which one of the following reacts vigorously with the water? Okay, so answer is sodium. Then see, minerals are now these questions. Now remaining questions, it is related to our coal and petroleum and only related to the point coal. So minerals are what? Natural resources, inexhaustible natural resources and exhaustible natural resources. Okay, now see the next 19. Which one is a not coal product? Now coal product we discussed before also. So coal tar, coal gas and lime, these three options are given for you. So in this, which one is a not a coal product? See, coal tar and coal gas is a coal product. So lime is remaining, so that is a not a coal product. Now see the next question, question number 20. Conversion of dead vegetation into coal is called as carbonization. Okay, this already we have discussed before also. Now see full form of LPG. LPG means what? Liquid petroleum gas. This you are learning from fifth standard. Okay, so full form of LPG, liquid petroleum gas. So option B is correct. Now see the next question, that is question number 22. A natural gas store under high pressure is called, okay? That natural gas is called as it store in a under high pressure, that is a CNG. See, it is where it is mostly it is used in our gas cylinder, it is CNG is there. Okay, then one product obtained by the process of destructive distillation are, which products are obtained? That is coke, coal tar, coal gas. Then list polluting fuel for vehicles is? This is a common question. So you all of you know that is a CNG. And last question, that is, when coal burns in air, then carbon dioxide is formed. Okay, so here we have discussed all 25 questions and just go through that PDF file. If you have any doubt regarding any question, please contact to me on that time. Okay, so means whatever the your doubts, that doubts will be clear and all the questions are very easy. Okay, so today we will stop here. Tomorrow we will continue with our next topic. Thank you.